Hello everyone, my name is Jenny Magera and I am the Digital Learning Coordinator for a network of 29 Chicago public schools here in the United States. Before this, I taught math and science to 4th and 5th graders. In both of these roles, I found that my key to success was clear communication. Thankfully, I found Google's answer to email, Gmail. In this Google for Education video, I'm going to share some great ways that you can use Gmail both in and out of your classroom, and why it's so much more than just an email program. The first thing that we're going to explore is how it helps you with organization. As an educator, it's very important that I can categorize my emails that come in and out of my email inbox. The way that most email programs do this is through folders. With this, you can take each email and put it in one folder. And that can be a problem if you want to categorize it in many different ways. Gmail has something else. It has labels. Labels are very powerful because you can put multiple labels on a single email. They allow me to sort them into different categories. For example, if a student like Kendrick emails me a question about math, I can label that email with emails from Kendrick, with a math label, and another label that says questions from students. I can even color code the different labels, and all of these labels are fully searchable from the Gmail search bar. This way, when I'm going through past communications, I can find it in a myriad of different ways. But wait, there's more! Perhaps as a busy educator, I don't have time to put labels on all of my email messages. That's where filters come to the rescue. I can set up automated filters that check each incoming message for keywords, the sender's email address, whether it has an attachment, and many other triggers. Based on these triggers, I can have Gmail label the email for me. The filters can also automatically forward the message, mark it as important, or send an automated canned response. Ooh, what's a canned response, you might wonder? It's an exciting feature you can activate in your Gmail settings to create templated responses. This has been incredibly helpful when fellow educators request support or students need certain feedback. I can type up an email complete with hyperlinks, formatting like bold text or highlighted passages, and then save it as a canned response. Then, when I work with a group of students or a team of educators, or receive an email asking for help, I already have a fully composed email ready to go. I can either send it myself or set up a filter to automatically send it for me. Gmail becomes even more powerful when teamed up with other Google products called Google Apps. Such Google Apps include Google Drive, Google Calendar, and Google Groups. One of the powerful things about Google is that all of these apps are integrated with one another. So, for example, if I want to create differentiated student groups for my reading class, I can create a Google group with their email addresses in it. Then I can send messages to that group email rather than typing each of their various addresses each time I need to write a message. This is especially helpful because unlike a contact group, Google Groups create an actual email address that can be used by anyone. As such, everyone in the group can use the same address to send communications to all the members. As an educator, we need to communicate with a variety of people for a variety of reasons. From students to parents to colleagues, these messages can easily overwhelm. Using Gmail for your correspondence can make it more effective and efficient, delivering your words of support, collaboration, or guidance with much more ease. If you're watching this video as part of the Basics series, check your understanding of this lesson by taking the Check Your Knowledge quiz below. For more information, check out the links attached to this lesson or visit google.com/education.